Hello everyone and welcome to Usitility. Today we are going to see how to play Lord of the Rings Rise to War on PC using the brand new BlueStacks 5, that is designed for blazing fast speed and high octane action. It packs a punch with mega performance upgrades and it has faster performance than any other high-end Android device or Android platform. We will be able to easily download and install Lord of the Rings Rise to War and enjoy the game on our Windows PC with keyboard, mouse and big screen thanks to BlueStacks 5, which is the Android emulator that we recommend to play Lord of the Rings Rise to War. So without further ado, let's get to it. First of all my friends, the first thing to do is to open our favorite internet browser. We open the one we use by default. Let's go to this URL that I have highlighted in green. There you are seeing it on the PC screen. There is no need to type it, because there's a link in the video description and as well in the first pinned comment. We landed on this page on the site of Usitility, exactly where we have a nice meticulous demonstration on the best way to obtain Lord of the Rings Rise to War on PC. We scroll lower a little bit and mouse click on the Download Game on PC button. After clicking on that link, we reach the site of BlueStacks. No panic, it is just the Android emulator that we will run to get access to this game Lord of the Rings Rise to War on the PC. As you can see here we get a number of advantages of using this emulator. Now we are on the way to proceed to download the Lord of the Rings Rise to War by simply clicking on the button play on BlueStacks that I have marked in green color. We then click on the button. And the download step starts and ends immediately. Voila, this is the download. It's a file we have to execute. The following step is to launch the executable file. Okay, so we click on this file. If we are on Windows 10 it will have asked us for permission to allow changes to the laptop or device. We said yes. I minimize the web browser to view the installation software better. The installer is quite simple. It includes a couple of options, install, and setup path. I am going to make it clear what setup path genuinely does. We basically just click it. So we discover that we have now here the path where the emulator will be put in. If we are planning to change for better this folder we have to click on the browse option, and we choose another directory and set up the emulator precisely where we wish. I will keep it where it is. I simply click on back. And I pick install. Now, there it is. The install begins and it is going to continue together with the download of all these MB that happens to be presented on the computer screen. When you save it on your hard drive, it could be a bit more or less MB. The data transfer speed will go faster or at a lower speed, based on your connection and depending on the performance of the emulator hosting servers. Now they are going superbly fast. The download is finished, and now it proceeds with the installation phase. With BlueStacks 5 you can even reduce RAM usage with a single click. Especially useful if you ever face performance-related problems. In addition, you can activate Eco Mode to enjoy 87% reduced CPU usage, 97% reduced GPU usage and easier multitasking. As you can see, BlueStacks 5 is built to provide stability and performance during long gaming sessions. The installation has already finished for me. Now, the emulator has actually been launched successfully. As you can see, at the bottom of the screen, there's a progress bar which will advance to the right when it has reached the ending, the emulator is launched for the first time. In reality, the emulator is already launched, there for the first time. Before we continue, as you understand, it made a couple of icons right here on the computer desktop. The BlueStacks and BlueStacks multi-instance. Note that the BlueStacks app icon is going to be the one we are focused on. Whenever we want to run Lord of the Rings Rise to War on the laptop or computer, we double-click this particular app icon and as a result use the emulator. The BlueStacks multi-instance icon allows you to launch multiple emulator instances. And with BlueStacks 5's new improved multi-instance manager in Eco Mode, players can run more game instances faster and with less lag. Let's make the following step, which is actually a must, and that's to visit the Google Play Store. And we will mouse-click on Play Store. As you can discover the Google Play is presented. There we are required to sign in. At this moment, the moment we are on this page, we are required to begin doing this next phase that is definitely compulsory. So we just click on, sign in. Now it announces, checking info. It may once in a while get stuck in, checking info, and so it fails to continue. If so, you should try to connect to your account after a few hours but it will surely most probably be sorted out. Now we shall type in our login name and password. The email really needs to be a Gmail email as well as its related password. For example, you could use the same email you are using currently in your own YouTube account. Thus I will provide my details and I will revisit when I have completed it. That's it, information inserted. Find out Google welcoming us and providing us the twos. We must say yes to all of them by pressing, I agree. Next, it allows us to backup to the Google Cloud. You can also leave it checked and this will generate a backup of the data on that device to Google Drive. I am not going to select it, you can make use of this feature if you like. We click accept. Google Play is started automatically and completely on its own. To install the app, we would need to get to the emulator desktop for Android by left-clicking this app icon marked in green. Right now that we are exploring the desktop of this emulator for Android, we observe that we come with there the install app game option. We mouse-click on the button. There we access to the video game. Let's click on there on the install choice that I'm just presenting now in green. And this will initiate the setup. Presently it should install the Android game. It typically takes a little while or it may just be very fast. It all relies upon on the connection to the web. It's just completed setting up. Now, let's go to the emulator desktop by simply clicking on that option that I am presenting in green, if you want to use Lord of the Rings Rise to War for the very first time. We are at present on the emulator desktop, and as a consequence we're about to mouse click on the fresh Lord of the Rings Rise to War software icon which has been created. The Android game is launched for the first time on your computer. Currently there we get it, I am able to mouse click anywhere on the screen and also make use of the keyboard. I will talk about the volume level of that emulator. It is here. We use the icon of higher volume along with the icon of lower volume. This manner we are not going to depend on the Microsoft Windows volume to increase or decrease the audio of the emulator. And to appreciate the experience to the max, we will turn on the big screen, for which we have two alternatives. This is simply the first one. We then click on this software icon which I am basically designating in green. And the display screen is maximized, coming with one border at the top, one on the right side and the third one at the bottom. In case we aspire to experience the application in full screen, we hit that software icon. And we'd by now be experiencing and enjoying the video game in full screen function. To stop the complete screen setting, press the F11 key. And we'd at present play in normal computer screen setting. At present, I am ready to present you the computer keys mapping which is really surprisingly cool. That means we will certainly be in a position to use the game more effortlessly. The first point is to mouse click this app icon. It's now time to get the recommended adjustments. I'm going to let the normal settings, however if you desire to adjust it, you can achieve it with no problem. As you can see, the emulator is absolutely in our language. On occasion it happens that the emulator is presented in the erroneous language, such as, in Chinese language. And consequently to set it up in the correct language we go there to the cogwheel. And right here inside of many other configurations, we just click on the language drop down. We will go with the language we need, Spanish, Chinese, and so on. Once the language is chosen, we would save, the emulator will reboot, along with the Android game, the next time we use it, would as well be in the chosen language. At this moment, you will find another element that we have to take into account, and it's that we will get a message from Google telling you that a brand new device has been associated with our Google account. It will ask us if we're the individuals who have connected that electronic device. Of course, we may not get worried, considering that the emulator is simulating an Android tablet or smartphone. And to identify which electronic device is currently being emulated, we arrive here, to the cogwheel and we mouse click on it. Therefore we browse here to the model choice. And now we discover that the emulator is acting as a Samsung smartphone. And so we're going to receive an email saying that a new Samsung device has been connected to our Google account. That's all guys, so much for this video user demo. I believe you enjoyed it, especially that everyone thought it was handy. If that's the case, allow it a good like, subscribe to the channel, and if you have feedback, concerns or ideas, let them in the comment area below. You could also leave a comment on my Twitch channel, I perform live streams occasionally, you get it below in the video description and in the first pinned comment. Check out any of those video tutorials that happens to be appearing on the screen and see you in the following videos. Bye.